Friday nights in the fall. It's when hits become highlights.
Friday nights are special. I mean, I'm a senior, and I know it's going to be something I miss a lot. But, I mean, they're crazy. There's just nothing like them.
Where cheers echo into the night sky.
Let's go, Tigers!
When the lights shine the brightest.
Friday nights are just, I think they're the highlight of my week. Just everything I look forward to that whole week until it's that day. And then, you know, right before that game, nerves are rattling. It's just an awesome feeling.
Moments become immortal.
As your 9A champions, 55-18 is your final score. Howard claims the championship.
But before kickoff, a lot of work needs to happen. Game day for head coach Pat Rummel starts in a way you may not expect. Giving the field a fresh cut.
When I first got here, we had some of our janitors did the work on it, and they were really good because they'd been here for a while, so I didn't have to do any of that stuff. Then they retired, and then nobody else kind of took it over, so I think one or two of them might have tried, and it wasn't a job that I liked how it was done. So I just figured from then on, you know, if I wanted it done how I wanted it done, I had to do it myself.
Pat Roma, his field is his baby. He takes care of that night and day, make sure it's ready to go.
Your football field is sort of an imprint of what your community's like. And I think if you have a sloppy field and one that's not taken care of, it kind of symbolizes maybe a little bit about your community. So that's just always been my theory. And so obviously we try to keep top-notch things out here, and I like to make it so when people see our field, it kind of symbolizes Howard as the school we are and the community we have here.
With the grass looking good, the stands are ready for fans who've been filling them for years.
Oh, probably between the people in Canova, 50 years. You know, I've gone to football games when we were still in Canova, and then when they moved up here, I started coming to these games and supporting the kids.
Good blocking, guys.
Born and raised in Howard, been going to football as long as I can remember. I never missed a game, any sporting events, and we just love the community, love the pride of the Tigers, and it's just wonderful to be a part of it all.
The time I told him I had to get out to the football, that's when I broke my hip, and I had surgery on a Thursday. And I said I was going to be out the next day to watch the playoff game here. I told them I was just going to leave, but they let me out. And I just watched it at home that night, and we got beat.
It really just shows like how much the football team and means to our community, and it's just really fun to get everyone together and show how much it means to us.
The Tiger fans now fill the stands, continuing the rich tradition that is Howard Tiger football.
At the beginning of the year, every year, it's right on our offensive playbook that we get handed out, and it says tradition doesn't graduate. That's a big thing for us. We know we always have big shoes to fill coming up, but it's a new year. It's not last year. It's not next year. We're just looking to be successful.
Just Howard Tiger football. We're going to see a lot of alumni back on the field, and they want to come back, and they want to cheer on these kids that they've either played with or that they've known since they were little. Me working at the elementary, obviously, I see the kids that play football at recess, the kindergartners trying to play with the fifth graders, trying to be that Howard football that they know.
Yep, I was class of 96. We played on the football team, and we went from 9-man to 11-man for quite a long run there, and it was quite a learning experience, but we had a lot of fun with it, and it's just a thrill to be out on the field and a thrill to be in the stands watching my son now.
Go Big Flex! Go Big Flex!
My brothers played 2 years ago and 4 years ago or whatever, and now I'm a cheerleader and kind of following the whole Howard tradition, and here we are today.
It's meant a lot. It's just, I grew up around football. It's always just kind of been part of me. It runs deep in my family. It's really a fun sport for me to play in.
Number 30, Griffin Club.
The easiest part of my week is Friday night when the game starts. when the kickoff happens, that's obviously the most fun for me.